Have you ever thought of starting with the pedal down, clearing it on the E flat, and then playing the next chord? I know it doesn't go kosher with Chopin, okay? The thing is that the piano has a ring when we put pedal on, and the piano has no overtones. We don't have that. If you start the first chord without pedal, you start with a naked piano, meaning all you're gonna get is that E flat minor chord. The minute you put the pedal down on E flat, the piano all of a sudden is gonna go down, better off, I think, and again, since Martin, to start with the pedal and go pedal down. Ba-da, clear on the E flat, put the pedal back down on the E flat as you hold it, and go. Because where you're thinking is da-da, pa, the second chord is weaker than the first chord, you lead into the second chord. Seems illogical to lead to the second chord because I'll tell you why, the piano dies, the piano does a crescendo, right? So in reality, it almost seems logical that the stress by Chopin is on the chord that is unstable, not that the chord is stable. Then he colors the stable chord by adding all these overtones on top. Okay? What you can also do with the overtones on top, and you do it very beautiful throughout. Okay, we're talking naval lit here. Okay? We're not talking anything big. Make sure that you know exactly where those notes are. Now you notice something about this piano that I noticed more so now is that this B flat and this C are different voices. You notice how sharp this is. Right. So what you have to do as a professional, then you're almost there. What you have to do is if you hear that B flat come out a bit too much, bring out the C right. Di-da-di-da-di-da-da. Then with that warning, you plunk down the soft pedal for your second one, and you ease up the B flat when you play the C. That's a trick for another time, okay? But meaning, these are things we have to react to the way, let's say, a pilot reacts to having a windstorm come over him at first in order to balance the plane. Okay, that's all we're dealing, basically, with this thing. Try just for the heck of it. Pedal down on the first one. And you will hear that there is more of an overtone series immediately rises. Right now, what you're getting is, instead of, just try, just for the heck of it. You have the pedal down, so you hear my overtones, right? I wish people would listen. Put the pedal down. Incredible. That's what's available to us. Try it. Put the pedal down, look clear this mess first, and then put the pedal down, and then clear on the E flat. Go ahead. Go ahead, do this. Ta-da, clear, put it back down. So you don't get the E flat as part of the chord, is what I'm trying to avoid. Because you notice what he writes it, the E flat as a resolution condition. Now, you don't want this anymore. You have to play again. See, to me that's more palpable. It goes from wet to wet, and now continue your run going up by paying careful attention and knowing where you are. Very careful.
doesn't become ta da ta da ta da separated. Make it come out of this. Do this last progression for me. Right, but then you clear really fast here. So you're going da 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 da. You're going from wet to dry, like immediately. You're going to have to fiddle with your foot a little bit more, not to let the piano completely go dry on you right after that. Because right now you're getting like two different percussion sections. You're not consistent. It has to stay the same. But I know we want to make an innuendo to bring in the tune. Great, but you can't do it by just dropping the pedal out. You have to do it more slowly. Whether you wiggle your foot, depending on your instrument, whether you half pedal it, I don't care. But you just cannot go from wet to dry so soon. Unless sometimes you want that effect. Impressionistic music in particular sometimes works really well that way. Romantic music doesn't necessarily work that way very well. Okay? Can you begin that? Can you give me the chorale again? Dee da da dum. Everybody says Bach must be clean. And then my favorite moves, and I'll show you. Just for the sake of this particular note, let me prove to you a point. You know what a pedal is? Pedal is acoustic. Pedal is not about tying notes together. And a perfect example is always use Bach. If you want to play an intimate thing, I'm playing in your living room, I'll play it this way. The first pedal and fugue from book two. I'll go. Single one of these notes, I'll play it this way. I want to play it for you in the Church of Saint-Sulpice piece in the middle of Paris. I'll play it for you this way. Sometimes engage, sometimes just out to lunch. Can you engage it the way you engage the melody? Because you're all there with the melody. Can you be all there with your left hand? That's like leaving the band behind. That's like the singer trying to sing something expressive and the band's talking to each other. Okay? Shake your left hand. Can you play the left hand by itself? That epiphany in mind, can you play this middle section?
I'm dismissed.
With paying attention to the LSD. The overtone series kind of kicked up a little bit. Right there, you use that foot of yours to clean out some of the mess. How much of it? Depending on the piano, depending on your mess. Play from there one more time. Right, and that way you basically do this without going snap. Okay? But what's winning right now is the beauty of your left hand that's making your right hand sound even more expressive than you already feel. Don't please don't leave that behind. We leave too many left hands to chance. And we pay the price for it. We listen to the performance, you're going to worse left hand. Okay? Don't do that. You're too good for it. Okay. If you can you go from shaking your left hand as well as you do. No, pay attention to, after the initial one, you pay attention to the other ones that continue. Don't just play. Are you playing with a firm bridge? Are you playing firm here? Another hand. Right, make sure that's firm, meaning that whatever you get, it's gonna be the same. Not, don't let it go and then retrace. Keep it. And that does mean to be tight. And not just send the bridge because we lose touch with the piano and then we get out of the keyboard.
This is
the very important. I rarely get up off the piano. I just don't see any need for it because the piano will repeat the minute you get there. There's no need for this. Recording of that song. me the very tale of the beast. Are we out of time yet? No.
Yeah.
Oh, we're almost out of time. Can you play me the very tale of the beast?
The
objects?
Yeah.
Right. Right there. Yeah. Right when the color. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, we need to balance, but you can't submerge it. And you're going to be a little bit pickier with your foot about doing this. Well, you're going to get, you're going to get this sort of clearing. Constantly keep moving your foot. Go. Talented. He played a great addition.